This is your last lesson in solving linear equations. You are solving multi-step linear equations when x is on both sides of the equation, and you may need to simplify each side. Your goal is to obtain the variable alone on one side, so you have your variable equal to a number. You are going to undo what is happening to the variable to solve the equation. To reach the goal, you first need to simplify both sides to the form of mx plus b. That means a number times the variable plus another number. You can only have two terms on each side before you start undoing what is happening to the variable. So you're simplifying both sides by using the distributive property and combining similar terms. After you have it simplified, you pick any term to move to the other side by adding and subtracting only. Once you have chosen that term and moved it to the other side, it determines what term you're going to move next, because you want your variables on one side and your constants on the other side. You will move the variables to one side and the constants to the other side by adding and subtracting only. So if you have something added, you subtract. If you have something subtracted, you add. Inverse operations. You will end up with your variable times or divided by a number, and you need to get rid of that number, so you're going to do the inverse operations for multiplication and division. You want to get the variable alone. The first example is 5 times the quantity x minus 1 plus 9 equals 2 times the quantity 3x minus 6. I want to use my distributive property and get rid of my parentheses. So I'm going to multiply 5 times the x and 5 times the negative 1. The sign always goes with the number that follows. So it goes, the minus sign goes with the 1. You want to multiply 2 times the 3x and 2 times the negative 6. The sign always goes with the number that follows. When I distribute, I end up with 5x minus 5 plus 9 equals 6x minus 12. Now I want to combine my similar terms. On the left-hand side, my similar terms are the negative 5 and the plus 9. On the right-hand side, I have no similar terms because I have an x attached to the 6, but there is no x attached to the 12. When I combine the similar terms on the left-hand side, negative 5 plus 9, I get plus 4. So I now have 5x plus 4 equals 6x minus 12. Now comes the time where I start to undo what is happening to the x. And what I do to one side, I must do to the other side. So I pick any term, and I am going to choose the plus 4, move it to the other side by subtracting 4 from both sides. When I subtract 4 from both sides, I end up with 5x equals 6x minus 16. Now I want to move my variables to one side and my constants to the other side. So I'm going to subtract 6x from both sides. I end up with negative x equals negative 16. I want x. I don't want negative x. And this is negative 1 times x. So I'm going to undo the multiplication by dividing both sides by negative 1. When I do that, I get x equals 16. My final answer is x equals 16. My second example is 11 minus 3 times the quantity x plus 4 equals negative the quantity 17 minus x plus 4x. I need to get rid of my parentheses, so I'm going to distribute on each side. I am first going to distribute the negative 3. The sign goes with the number that follows. The negative 3 is going to be multiplied by the x, and then it's going to be multiplied by the 4. On the right-hand side, I'm going to distribute the negative 1. When there's nothing listed, it's a 1, because 1 times any number is itself. I want to distribute the negative 1 to the 17 and to the negative x. When I do my distribution, I end up with 11 minus 3x minus 12 equals negative 17 plus x plus 4x. Now I'm going to combine my similar terms so I get it in the form of mx plus b on both sides of the equation. So my similar terms on the left-hand side is 11 and negative 12. And on the right-hand side, I have x and I have 4x. When I combine my similar terms, I end up with negative 3x minus 1 equals negative 17 plus 5x. Now I'm going to pick a term to move to the other side. I'm going to choose 5x this time. You can choose any term. I'm going to choose 5x. Since I have positive 5x, I'm going to subtract 5x from both sides. When I subtract 5x from both sides, I get negative 8x minus 1 equals negative 17. I want my variables on one side and my constants on the other side. Since this side has a variable and a constant, I'm going to move the constant to the other side since this only has a constant. So to move the negative 1 to the other side, I'm going to add 1 to both sides. I get negative 8x equals negative 16. I want to get rid of the negative 8 in front of the x, which is being multiplied. So I divide both sides by negative 8. I end up with x equals positive 2. X equals 2 is my final answer. My third example is negative 1/4 times x minus 12 plus 2 equals 3/4. Times 20 minus x. Again, I need to distribute first. Now, if you are not okay with fractions, remember you can use a calculator on anything that you're doing in this class. So I want to take a negative 1/4 and multiply it by x. And then I want to multiply that negative 1/4 by negative 12. I want to take 3/4 and multiply it by 20. And then I want to take the 3/4 and multiply it by negative x. After I distribute, I will end up with negative 1/4 x plus 3. I get the plus 3 because a negative times a negative is a positive, and 1/4 times 12 is really 12 divided by 4. Which is 3. And then I have plus 2 equals 15. I get 15 by taking 4 into 20 5 times. 5 times 3 is 15. And minus 3/4 x. My similar terms on the left-hand side are the 3 and the 2. On the right-hand side, I have no similar terms because there's no x with the 15 and there's an x with the 3/4. So when I combine my similar terms, I get negative 1/4 x plus 5 equals 15 minus 3/4 x. I'm going to pick any term to move to the other side. 5 to the other side. So I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides. I get negative 1/4 x equals 10 minus 3/4 x. I need to move this minus 3/4 x to the other side, so I'm going to undo it by adding it to both sides. I get 2x divided by 4, because this is common denominators. Negative 1 plus 3 is 2. My common denominator is 4, so I have 2x divided by 4 equals 10, because this is 0. I want to undo my division and my multiplication at the same time, so I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal 4/2 on both sides. When I do that, I end up with x equals 10 times 4 is 40 divided by 2. 40 divided by 2 is 20. So my final answer is x equals 20. In summary, I first simplify both sides of the equal sign to the form of mx plus b on both sides, two terms. I use the distributive property and I combine similar terms to simplify both sides. Then what I do on one side, I do on the other side because I'm undoing what is happening to the x. I pick a term to move to the other side by adding or subtracting only. And then I move all the variables to one side and the constants to the other side by adding and subtracting only. And then I have a number either times my variable or my variable divided by a number, which I need to get rid of. So I inverse my multiplication or division to solve for x and get the x alone.